So I'm back again, and today I'm going to give you some tips for packing, like for holidays. And going on a holiday is the time right now. So the summer season is on, and you must be thinking of like where to go, what to plan, what to pack. So the packing part, let me take care of that for you. So the thing is, when we pack for holidays, we are like confused what to carry, what to pack, what clothes to carry, like what will look good on me, what will look good on pictures. So that's another big thing nowadays. So let me tell you like what all things you can consider while packing for holidays. So let's say the clothing part basically. So for the clothing part, what you can do is like, it's a different thing which we'll think, but you should check the weather. So go to apps which gives you weather information and check how the weather is going to be on the particular day you're planning to go over there. So like it's sunny, it's rainy, it's windy, what exactly it's going to be. And that way it will get more easier for you to know like what you all should you pack. So if it's going to be sunny, so you can pack light clothes. You can carry like sunblock along with you. Sunblock is something which you should carry any which ways along with you, but that's another good tip, like that would make you remember to pack that in your bag. So like that's one more thing. Okay, so the weather is one thing which you should always check before vacation. Okay, and next thing. Okay, so pack according to the events which you are going to do. Like if it's your proper plan trip, so you would know like what are you going to do, like whether you're going to walk a lot, whether you're going to track, whether you're going to parties, what are you going to do. So pack according to that. So if you're going on track or you're going to walk a lot, like if you go to Paris, you walk a lot. So according to that, pack like nice good pair of shoes along with you, so that you know your walking would be easy. You can wear that and go, so that it doesn't take much space in your backpack. And okay, next thing is like what I prefer is I always prefer to carry a backpack rather than having a carry-on bag along with me. So it's comparatively light, it's easy to keep anywhere, and that way you will pack in the space which is available to you. So that way you'll pack less. So that's a good thing. According to me, it's totally up to you, like how you want to do it. But for me, that's a very good thing. And when you travel in Europe, it's always good to like just have a, you know, carry on luggage with you, and all the check-in, you know, that cost you money additional. So it's always good to have like one backpack. That's it, nothing more than that. Okay, so coming to the packing. Okay, so my tip for you is pack light for the summer season, I'm telling you. Okay, so always pack lighter clothes, linen, cottons, t-shirts, which are more comfortable, yeah, which looks good also and plus are comfortable also. And shoes, which I told you should always, like, it's a very good thing to carry shoes. And if you are like planning to go on beach, and so pack according to that, like all the bikinis which you are planning to take, the flip-flops you want to take. So those are very small things which can be easily packed into your backpack. And if you think the temperature is going to be windy or it's going to rain, so you can carry an additional jacket along with you. Carrying a jacket is any which way is a good thing to carry, like a thing basically, something which would protect you from like wind, rain, and any you know colder temperature you go to, a slighter colder temperature I'm talking about. So it's always good to carry a small jacket along with you. It's a good thing. You can carry a leather jacket, so that's also a different thing, totally up to you. Okay, and what else you should consider, like always carry an additional pair of clothes along with you. One or two, it's to, you can, you know, take a guess, like depending upon the space you have, but always carry an additional, like if you plan to go for 4 days and you think of like carrying four clothes, that's it. No, carry additional pair. There could be like incidences like you fell in mud. I'm just giving an example, like your clothes are wet, anything could happen. So it's good to always have an extra pair. Undergarments, carry additional pairs of undergarments with you any time. That's a very good thing to do. And clothing wise, this is important. Carry if your mostly your holiday doesn't involve any partying, still carry a dress along with you. That will be like, you know, sometime you feel like going partying, so it's always good to have a dress along with you. Okay, and my funda, like what I think about, you know, traveling is I should be comfortable in the clothes I wear. Like earlier when I used to think like, okay, I'm going to travel Europe or go to different places, I should, you know, wear fancy dresses, have good Instagram pics. But like that is good for certain times. But if you're not comfortable and you are every time, you know, checking whether it's not getting dirty, or if you're not comfortable in it, then there's no use. So like if you want, you can carry some dresses, like one or two if it comes in your bag, and like wear them, go out, have take some cool pics and then come back. But most probably, according to what I would suggest you, is carry comfortable clothes, something which you're more comfortable wearing and walking around and not like worrying about them. That's the most important thing. Okay, when you like pack in a backpack, it's what you can do is like you can roll your clothes and put it at the bottom. So like if you carry a backpack, first like put all your clothes, roll it up and put, you know, keep stacking it so you'll get proper spacing for it. And on top of that, then you pack your cosmetics, what you want to carry along with you. The cosmetics could be like very basic, any cosmetics which you carry like when you travel any place. So it could be your toiletries, your toothbrush, your paste, your shampoo, and all the other makeups of which you carry along with you. So there are various videos which would tell you like how you can do it in a smaller space. You can go and look for that. There are certain, you know, you get certain small bottles, 100 ml bottles also. So you can buy those also and carry those. So the clothes goes first. Always like all your undergarments, you pack it in a separate bag. Like a polythene or a small bag or anything which you have handy at your place. Clothes in a small bag, your undergarment should be there so that it doesn't get like lost in all your clothes. Then your cosmetics, and then all the accessories which you have, the camera or the phone, anything. Or if your backpack has a back slot for laptop, first put that and then put the rest of the thing. And like keep a separate space so that you can pick up your laptop during the check-in time in on airport. So that's just when you go on airport. For the trains and buses, that won't matter much. So consider that. That's it. That's the basic minimum thing you should do. Doesn't require much thought. Just few pointers you should consider before packing. Hope it helps. And if you have any queries, please put them in the comment section below. If you want to know more, let me know that so that I can put some more information out there. And if you want me to make, you know, videos on some topics, please let me know in the comment section below. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. And subscribe to my channel for more such videos.